if you could please take your seats and we'll get this started. So I'll begin by reading the Indigenous Solidarity Statement. So we'd like to begin by acknowledging that Concordia University is located on unceded Indigenous lands. The Ganyangehaga Nation is recognized as the custodians of the lands and waters on which we gather today. Jojage/Montreal is historically known as a gathering place for many First Nations. Today it is home to a diverse population of Indigenous and other peoples. We respect the continued connections with the past, present, and future in our ongoing relationships with Indigenous and other peoples within the Montreal community. So with that, we'll move to roll call, and I have two councillor requests for excusal and one executive. So the councillors are Amma and Selena, who could not be here, and Eduardo has an event, I believe, and will be coming in and out, so he'll likely miss at least 60 minutes of the meeting. Yes, Jared?
I wish to omnibus and excuse them all.
Okay, your second. Elias, is there any opposition to excusing? All right, so that carries. And we can move on to approval of the agenda. So anyone who sent me a motion after Friday, we just need to state it that it needs to be in the agenda. So, yes.
Do you have to accept all of them?
No, that's what the approval of the agenda motion voting is for. So we did have some resignations on committees since I've sent out the agenda. So Peter resigned from the Loyola committee and Hershey resigned from the CSU, and in doing so gave up a seat on the sustainability committee, the appointments committee, and the online opt-out committee. So is everyone okay if I put all those committees on the agenda? Yes.
Yeah, there's also student life material.
Oh, okay. That's a lot of committees. Following a resignation?
Yeah.
Sean, you had something to add to the agenda?
Yes. It was a motion regarding the campaigns coordinator position.
All right. Isaiah?
Wait, can I motion to not put that on the agenda?
We can deal with that, I guess. I think it might be best to put it on the agenda and then move to table it indefinitely if you're not down with it.
But if it's not on the agenda, then like we don't even have a table indefinitely.
Okay, so there's a motion on the table to not consider the motion regarding clubs.
I second it.
Okay, seconded by Victoria. Do you want to explain, do you want to motivate for?
You mean the whole motion?
Or sorry, actually, Isaiah, do you want to motivate for why it shouldn't be on the agenda?
Okay, so upon receiving the motion, previous counselors had discussed with me their take on it. But for those of you who are new to the council, we already discussed a similar issue in which involved the council trying to dictate the executives to be hiring. Anything to do with hiring is explicitly between the executive and the QP union. So even putting this on agenda and going through a vote, it's like at the end of the day, it's supposed to hiring activities go between the executive and the QP unionized executive. So bringing it to council would just waste time and energy going around and probably frustrate a lot of people in the room.
Okay, Sean?
Ultimately, myself and all the councillors who are sitting here today have a responsibility to that of the entire student union, that being the students who voted and voted for us. This also includes holding the student union responsible to both its finances and, even more importantly, to student life as a whole. This motion is done entirely to help that responsibility. And that is why I believe, why we submitted it, and why I believe it should be on the agenda.
Thank you. Isaiah,
on the first. But in the point of how much research was done prior to bringing the motion, like I guess it's a direct question, how much research and what type of research was done prior to bringing the motion to council? Because if this is a motion to kind of try to figure out what to do without the grounds of proper, like, looking into the situation, and I find it...
Point of information.
Do you want to...
Direct, like, how much research, because from...
This has actually been something I've been looking into shortly before the resumption of classes is something I've been looking over a number of weeks. I have actually looked into this, the union of employees within the student union, the finances of this position, and the finances available to the union as a whole. This has not been done out of just a all of a sudden motion, but it has been researched and prepared.
Thank you. Hirsch, sorry.
Well, it's a question for Chris.
What is it?
So, well, one of the points brought up was about QP and whatnot. I'm assuming you've looked into these things from the legal aspect. Is his motion actually able to go forward?
Well, you're able to debate it, but it's something council can do, but it doesn't mean council has to discuss it, right? If you want, like right now what we're voting on is, will we discuss it today? And that's up to the room.
Okay, thank you. Isaiah?
In the sense of like, let me clarify what I mean by research. Anyone can go in an Excel sheet, look at the budget that Desiree so accurately put together, and look at numbers, but did anyone go and even approach the staff, approach the different executives, approach the QP executives? Were anybody consulted before we even come up to a motion? Or was this all, let's say, secondhand research done from a third party looking? That's it.
I will respond. Actually, yes, there have been multiple executives consulted. As it turns out, I had not been the only one looking into this issue before I had submitted it. As it turns out, another fellow counselor, Howard, had been looking into it as well. He'd actually consulted you personally on this, and I'd been made aware of this. Additionally, I had been talked to other executives, such as Chris, and I also, Howard himself had also approached Marin about this. And I also am aware of QPE 4512 and their sort of issues with the student union. I'm also been made aware that they are supposed, or been told that they supposedly have some sort of 4 grievances. However, these grievances have expired due to the time that has elapsed. And furthermore, QPE is being led by a president who is not even a CSU employee at this point in time. As such, I even must question how we can even talk to them in good faith.
Thank you. Naomi?
So I'm really confused what's going on. Can I motion to vote on this?
You'd like to call the question?
Yes, I'd like to call the question.
Okay. Do you have a second to call the question?
Second.
Esther, is there any opposition to calling the question? Okay, so all those in favor of considering this, sorry, I'm turning your motion upside down, Isaiah, just for so we don't do a double negative. All those in favor of considering the motion regarding clubs coordinator, please raise your placards. 11, all those opposed. 5, 6, 7, and any abstentions? What? All right, so it carries. Let me just check the math, because I believe it requires a 2/3 because it wasn't submitted by Friday. I just want to confirm that it is a 2/3.
It's below 2/3.
No, I just want to confirm in the regs that it's a 2/3 because actually we have never done this. Sorry, just give me a minute. There we go. Any additional item to be considered at a council meeting brought without respecting the delays can be considered with a 3/4 majority of council. So it does not get a 3/4 majority, and therefore it won't be discussed today. So I will remove that from the agenda. That being said, is there anything else that needs to be added or removed, amended? Yes.
I'd like to pull the midterm report.
Okay.
I will put that right after setting election dates. Is there anything else that needs to be added, modified, subtracted from the agenda? If everyone's okay with it, is it okay if we put the CEO report under presentation and guest speakers, since we have the CEO with us, and to avoid them waiting around for a long time, we will deal with that first. So if there is nothing further, I just need a motion to approve the agenda and all items under consent. Selman?
I'll second. Approve the agenda.
Okay, I'll second it.
Seconded by Victoria. Is there any opposition to approving the agenda? All right. So in that case, the agenda is approved, and I will just export this to a PDF and put it in the group so you can all follow along. With that, we are on the ratification of the CEO report, so I'll open the floor to Florian if you want to say anything about the report first.
It's pretty self-explanatory in the report. Everything went pretty well. I'm just here to answer questions,
okay,
if there's any.
At this point, I will open the floor to questions, and we'll follow our 20-minute agenda point. Patrick.
I do have a question for the CEO. Basically, under the rules, it says that you're supposed to publish all the complaints that received, and I know very well that mine was not published in the report. I just wanted to know why that didn't happen.
Well, either way, it wasn't.
Well, most of the emails I receive are complaints, so I guess you would depend on what you mean by a complaint. I guess there's different degrees of how serious they are. I only put the ones that I think are pretty, that raises actual questions about the elections, if you know what I mean. What was your complaint?
Did you want to follow up?
I mean, that's not really the point of what I'm trying to say, is that in your report you're supposed to do that. I just was wondering why that didn't happen. I'm presuming you didn't know about that.
Did I answer your complaint?
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying you're supposed to publicly state all the complaints that you received during the campaign in your report.
I'm not sure.
It's okay if you don't know. Just say you don't know.
All right, thank you. Are there any other questions? Victoria?
I just need to find it. I have questions on it. Sorry.
The report
Yeah, absolutely.
When this discussion is over,
folks, excuse me, there's a lot of chatter going on in the background.
Whenever this discussion ends, I just want to flag that I'd like to bring up Matt's here at the end of it.
Oh.
Because he'd like to make some remarks in closed session.
Okay.
Yeah, that'll be after.
Okay.
On this agenda point in closed session.
Thank you. Is there anything further? Or Victoria, are you still looking at the report?
No, it's just because I had one with like actual writing on it, so like I won't feel like it's fine. The only general comment I will make is that
your report just needs to be a bit more structured or a bit more like you can use the appendix. It was the only thing I found, it was a bit messy, and some of it just wasn't clear, but unfortunately, I can't even tell you what it was, but if you want to speak about it, maybe I can help you so the next time it's just a bit better. That's all I really want to say. Unfortunately, again, I can't find the one I edited, but yeah. Sorry. Thank you, Will. It was 2 weeks ago. I'm so sorry. Or 3 weeks ago at this point.
I had some questions for you. So I genuinely wanted to have your opinion on this. So a lot of the complaints that we have been hearing about is the fact that either that you were unavailable to answer questions, or would respond to them late, or perhaps, or would refer them to somebody else. So what I want to know is, do you think that you are able to carry out this mandate properly? What type of assistance would you require? What would you advise us for us to do in next year? Like, what did you need to do your role better?
That's a big question. I think a lot of people ask questions that can be answered by reading through the CSU, the standing regulations. And that's why I don't spend that much time. I mean, I just refer them to the standing regulations, like, hey, read them, you're supposed to read them. But that's pretty much it.
Okay,
so
So then for next year, for example,
what would you advise for the CEO or for the team? If ever you would want to restructure it, like how would you think, what would you need more? If you need another person on deck during elections, if we had an electoral committee, what would be the different type of roles that would need to be handled? Like we need one specific person just to answer this, or one specific person to do this.
I think the DEOs should be able to answer complaints and general emails. And if they need more, more in-depth answer, then they can send forward it to me. But I think DEOs should have another role in this, not just organize the debates and put posters up.
Thank you.
Yeah. Is there any kind of specific reason why in the bylaws you're supposed to give all the reports about the elections 5 days after the results have been submitted? Is there any reason why we have to wait until literally the next semester to get this report?
No idea.
So,
yes, Chris, sorry.
Yeah, so on that, I'd like to move into a closed session so Mathieu could share his experiences with us. And I would be asking for an exemption for Mathieu to be made so he could also be in closed session.
Right. Do we have a second? Salman, is there any opposition to entering closed session? Okay, so in that case, I just ask anyone that's not executive, minute keeper, myself, or judicial board to please leave the room, and we'll call you back in when we're in open session.
And
which is every 2 weeks on Friday. We have one actually this Friday, so if you're on, you should show up this Friday. So that's just basically the availabilities.
Yeah, Elizabeth, did you want to mention something first?
Yeah, so this is... I'm giving up my seat on Senate, and I was appointed to this committee in, I think, October, because Maha was not able to be on it, as she was the one who was originally, she's not there, okay, as she was the one that was originally appointed. So I am dropping this committee with the intention to give, or, not, well, not me personally, like, single-handedly pass it to her, but I would love for her to regain her seat again, and as it was originally hers, and I took it in her stead, and I think that she'd be amazing on this committee, and so, yeah, was that me motivating for her?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
What time do you guys meet? Can you just repeat the time that you guys meet, and also the cocktail?
So you meet every 2 weeks, you meet for academic caucus, which is from 12 to 2. And then every month or so, there is a meeting of Senate, which lasts from approximately 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. So you'd have to have your afternoons booked every month or so.
On Tuesday?
No, Fridays.
Thank you. Mama?
Thank you so much. So... I was previously appointed by the counselors in this room, so I know that now we have a few new additions. But the reason why I was appointed for Senate was because while running, I wanted to make some concrete changes to the student body and to the student administration. Now, not only am I a qualified person for the role, but that being aside, I have already been trained for Senate. So the fact that someone is coming in mid-mandate is going to have to come in and pick up where we left off, having someone who is A, familiar with the administration, B, familiar with how the process works, because bureaucracy at Concordia, oh, it's surprising, all right. You would think. So when I first ran, the only reason why we had this one eligibility criteria that was not being able to met, and so now that has, even though it passed in September, it took until January to ratify. So it's only now that I can take my place in Senate if you guys ratify me one more time. So thank you. No, it's fine. So that's also one more thing that has to come into consideration is the fact that because I am already trained, because I am already experienced in how to deal in Senate, this would be a very convenient transition and also an easy transition for the rest of the year so that we can, so that Senate can carry out the rest of its mandate. And I hope that you guys all vote. Thank you.
Thank you. Did you have a quick question first?
Yeah, exactly. I lost track. Where exactly are we
We're
holding?
On six appointments, Senate.
Oh, okay. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Naomi?
Can I vote to nominate Maha? Is that a thing?
Yeah, do you want to move to appoint right away?
Yeah, move to appoint Maha to Senate.
Okay.
Can I motivate?
Yeah. Elizabeth, your motivation, Naomi?
Okay. Well, first of all, I just want to motivate, not only because Maha would do an excellent job on Senate, but also I know there's some new people, as she said, and I'm just going to stress it, but we had all initially voted for Maha to go on Senate, and due to the university's rules, which are very unjust and discriminatory, she was not able to do it. So I think that in good faith and as solidarity to our fellow colleague, we should really just reappoint her, and it should be, I think, unanimous.
Thank you. Jared?
Oh, I was literally about to do that. Yeah. No.
Can I call a question?
I just want to ask Naomi a question.
There's a motion on the table too. There's sort of two ways of doing it. You can either do nominations or just move straight to appoint, and somebody made a motion to appoint. Jeremiah.
Yeah, I just want to ask Naomi a question. When you said certain policies that you found were discriminatory, I'm just curious, can you give examples of what policies you're talking
about?
It's
because... Can I...
You don't have to...
Okay,
I
won't.
Because,
yeah,
I'm more familiar with what is being talked about.
Basically, back in September, the eligibility requirements for Senate were changed, but it took a time for them to go through Board of Governors. What she's referring to were the previous rules which barred Maha from sitting on it. That's basically what she's talking about.
Yeah, I understand, but why was she barred? Like, what was it that was...
I mean, that's Maha's personal situation.
Okay, I understand.
Okay,
I'm gonna move that up.
Okay, so if there's no further speakers list, we'll move to a vote. So all those in favor of appointing Maha, please raise your placards. All those opposed? 1, 2, and any extensions? 1, 2,
mine
is no. 3, okay, and Peter's no noted. And 3
extensions.
Can I also have my
noted?
Okay, so the 3 years in brackets. Sean, Hirsch, and Peter. Okay, so the appointment is ratified. And if there's nothing further on Senate, we can move on to the Loyola Committee. And Millie's, this one, where'd you go?
Could I be Millie's?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sure. The Loyola Committee is full of fun. If you love Loyola and you love committee, join Loyola Committee. No, but in all seriousness, if you care about Loyola issues and you want to be able to approve projects, vote on projects that that happen at Loyola, provide funding, help out the community, help Millie's with her portfolio as the Loyola coordinator, you could sit on this committee.
Okay, thank you. Peter?
Yeah, I just want to add one thing. So basically, this seat was supposed to be mine. I give it up. I just want to let everyone know, please choose wisely what committee you're going to sit on. If you know, I give it up because of my situation that I don't think would be fair for me to be sitting on this right now, but just do whatever I can on it.
Thank you. So is there anyone who'd like to appoint themselves to Loyola Committee? If not, it'll just come back. It'll keep coming back at the next meetings. Victoria?
I don't know. I was just going to advocate for a Loyola Committee. It's fun. We're there. I'm there. Hey, what's up? If anyone wants to join. But if no one wants to join, like, I guess we'll move on.
Sorry, I'm
at
John Wilson, and I don't have time anyway.
I'm at John Wilson. What's your point?
Okay.
I'm kidding.
Would anyone like to nominate themselves or somebody else? Jeremiah, please, to sit on the Loyola Committee.
No, I'm okay with that.
Okay, so if not, this will just come back next meeting as there's a seat open and it is in the standing regs that it will keep reappearing like a ghost. Sustainability Committee, also Millie's.
Great, I can say that one too. So Sustainability Committee, if you want to make a difference with sustainability at Concordia Campus, work with the different groups, give out funding to different groups, you could join the Sustainability Committee.
Okay. Yes, Hannah?
Nominate
myself. Okay.
Second.
Seconded by Jared.
Do
you have a question here?
When the meeting time is?
Well, I mean, Melise could speak to that, but is anybody here on sustainability?
Who knows the meeting time?
Esther? Or Lee?
So when do you guys meet?
really whenever we're available, we do have some difficulty finding a time where all of us are. so just whenever, we send a win to meet out about 2 weeks in advance of a meeting.
Thank you. Okay, so,
this point.
Like, do you need to move to
appoint
Hannah?
Sorry, yes.
So you
just
move to appoint Hannah?
Yes.
Yeah, sure,
okay.
Yes.
Okay. So
I was trying
second.
To, yes.
Naomi, okay, so all those in favor of appointing Hannah to the Sustainability Committee, please raise your placards.
4, 5, 6,
7.
Okay.
15, all those opposed.
0,
and any extensions?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay, so that carries. Congratulations, you are on the Sustainability Committee. And there is a seat on a point. Yes, Selma?
Point appointment.
Talk about it.
Yeah, the next one's appointment is Eduardo's not here, so if you're on
yeah, because he just said. So, guys, we have one empty seat in Appointments Committee. So what we do is, like, we appoint people to sit on committees, member at large, for judicial board and all the student-based members on campus. So we are one member shot because Hershey Blackman resigned. So I would really like the people who are more passionate about, you know, getting something done. And we don't have a fixed schedule, but when we meet for longer hours. So if you are coming in, just be ready for like 6-7 hours meeting because we do interviews and it's long hours.
Just a
That's
point
it.
Of information, Eduardo said you needed 3 hours on Fridays to be order in order
it's
to be
not
on.
Specific.
It's not a point of information.
Okay, it's not? Sorry.
It's not specific.
Oh, okay.
He said Fridays.
Thank you.
He says Fridays, but it's not 100%.
Okay, I think we'll figure this out.
He told me.
Yes, I nominate myself to be on the committee.
Okay, we have a second. James. Maha?
I nominate Christiane for Appointments Committee.
Okay.
May I motivate?
Do we have your consent, sorry?
Yeah.
And Hannah?
I would nominate Elizabeth.
Do we have your consent?
Yes.
Okay. And Sean?
I nominate myself for Appointments Committee.
Okay, so second.
Okay, I resign. Resign.
You don't want it? Okay. Okay, we have Christiane, Elizabeth, and Sean. Is there anything further? Yes, Chris?
I'd just like to motivate for Sean. Sean works really hard when he puts his mind to things, and I think he'd be a very useful and hardworking person on this committee.
Okay, so with that, we can move around the room and see, and go through personal motivations. If anyone wants to say why they want to be on the committee, quick. Maha, did you want to say something before?
No, I'm sorry. So when I nominate somebody, aren't I supposed to motivate for them as well?
You can.
Okay.
Yeah.
May I?
We'll just go through like self-motivations and then other people motivations. Christiane?
Can I actually rescind my,
yeah,
my thing that will happen?
Okay, Elizabeth?
Yeah, so I'd really like to sit on Appointments Committee because I would really like to take part in the hiring process of finding new people to sit on our committees, especially students at large, where we definitely tend to have a lack of that. I think I'd be good on this committee because I think that I'm very committed and that I would be able to be available as well, considering I dropped many committees. I think I would make a great part of this team. I know everyone on the committee, and I mean, if you like my work ethic and you think I'd be a good addition, then vote for me, I guess.
Thank
or
you.
Not.
Sean?
I currently don't sit on any committees whatsoever, and I also realize that Appointments Committee, for just filling positions and even more importantly through getting members at large, because For many people in the student body, they aren't even familiar with the CSU. And when I put my mind to something, as Chris mentioned, I get it done. And I think that being on this committee, I can really help get good people in positions and also perhaps even help it move a bit more quickly, which is kind of sometimes a problem from what I hear.
Okay, so that's why we can move into if anyone wants to motivate for their colleagues. And I have a speakers list of Naomi, Maha, Hannah, and... sorry, do you go by Mendel?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Okay, I was just reading your placard. All right. Naomi.
So I just kind of have a question first. We have in our bylaws or standing regs gender equity for hiring or appointments. Is that like a, that's a thing, or they haven't been approved? No? Okay. Well, anyways, there should be that. So, in the spirit of gender equality, I think that it would be fair, not only because Elizabeth is extremely qualified, she has a very good work ethic, she doesn't, I don't know how to say this, but she doesn't play politics, she's very mature in her decisions, and additionally, I think that having already, it's 3 or 4 men on the committee, I think that having a gender...
Point of information, the student that at large that we voted on is a woman.
Two counselors that are males, and then that's all I'm saying. I just think it's important to have that, and not just that, but also Elizabeth is extremely qualified, and I would urge everyone to vote for her.
Thank you. I'm vouching for Elizabeth. Despite her gender, despite everything, just based on her person. So based on her person, I work with her in 2 different committees. So I can personally attest to not only her work ethic, but also the sense of unbiasedness. And so what I really appreciate is that when somebody has a history of showing that A, they are accountable for their actions, and that B, they're able to make mature decisions without letting any personal bias come in hand, and that C, they make themselves available. She is always available for any of these things, and so the fact that that appointments committee has a very tedious task, that they have to make themselves available for 6-hour-long meetings, I know for a fact that this woman can do the job better than anyone else can. And so I motivate for her. Thank you.
Yeah, I would also like to motivate for Elizabeth because I think she's extremely qualified, extremely hardworking, and most of it has already been said by Maha, so I'm just going to stop talking now.
Thank you. Jared?
Hi,
There was one more person on the speaker's list, so chill.
There's one more person?
Yeah. Mendel's been raising his hand.
Okay, can I call it right after then? Can it be assumed that I did that? Thank you.
I'd like to motivate for Sean. While there are many new counselors and myself, so I don't think that history needs to be the most important decision regarding this. I have known Sean for a while. Again, not that important, but he's a hard worker and a sharp critical thinker. When he works on anything, he gets it done. I've known him in university and out of university, and he has my confidence.
Great, thank you. Okay, so with that, the speakers list is done, and your candidates are Elizabeth. Sorry?
It's automatic.
Yeah, it's automatic.
How many more do we need?
And like 6, 5.
No
one needs
to call.
No.
Between 2 counselors, yeah. It just automatically happens.
Thanks. Sorry for your.
It's fine. Okay. It's really easy. So, literally,
So there are no more nominations of our seats. It goes to $1.
I thought last time we just had to wait for someone to call us.
No, that's for a moment.
Yes. No, I know, but last time we did it.
Yeah, because that was just for one specific person. It was specifically saying, I want this person.
No, I'm saying.
I'll just give it a second. Okay, folks, so your candidates are Elizabeth, Sean, or abstain, if you would like to abstain.
Jeremiah, I think that was already documented. Because, like, who automatically lies? The question was, there was a potential nominee that wasn't clear that hadn't yet answered back. And we moved to a point, regardless of, like, not waiting for the end.
I think maybe what happened.
Oh!
Caitlin.
Yes, yeah, I'll be back in 2 seconds. Sorry. Thank you.
Oh, that's where you guys are. I thought you guys went out.
Caitlin!
Wait, Caitlin, you're missing one.
You missed Lauren.
I Adele.
I'm coming.
Thank you. Oh.
That's on camera.
Thank you.
Hi, Adele.
Coffee night.
I mean, I was working.
I used to work down there, and I was in organic lab, and I told him, I said out loud that I could go up to school if I wanted to, and then
she could have built a building of food.
No, I told him here. I was like, I have four assets. I just have to go up to school if I drive.
And then I
and then she exercised with me.
Normally it should be a piece of my heart or my heart.
Yeah, I'll just get acid at some time.
Yeah. Wow. But imagine not doing the
day. Yeah. Try getting out. 5 minutes.
All right, folks. Following the results of the secret ballot, congratulations, Sean. You are appointed to the appointments committee. And with that. As well, okay, folks, please be quiet. We're on the online opt-out committee because Hershey was on it and Hershey resigned. Though there was some talk of allowing them to stay in a student at-large role. I believe, Chris, you had mentioned that?
So I wanted to bring that up. So I spoke to Hershey and he said he'd be willing to stay on this committee. He said all committees, but I've been speaking to people about that and the logistics and wording and everything seems a bit complicated. But for this committee specifically, since it's like an ad hoc committee, I'd like to, and since the seat was reserved for an independent student and Mendel doesn't seem like you're willing to take it if, you know,
yeah,
if
I mean,
it's...
If Hershey's there, I'd rather Hershey do it. He was the original one who wanted it.
Yeah, but generally, like, I want to do a motion to just let Hershey stay on the committee since he's willing to still do the work. And, the motion is, be it resolved, that we allow Hershey to stay on the online opt-out committee.
Okay, do we have a second, Jared? Is there any opposition to this to this motion? Okay, so that carries unanimously. Hershey will remain on the online opt-out committee, so you can send him an email. And following the resignation of Esther from the student life and external committees, there are also seats on those. Is Eduardo here for student life? Okay, does anyone want to speak to student life? Lauren? Okay, so Lauren has the floor.
Okay, so we have around $40,000 a year that we hand out to special student projects, so we usually give money to people that are either, like we fund projects, like school projects, like master's projects, we fund events, we fund, like, pretty much, like small projects that try and help as many students as possible and enrich student life. So please join. We meet like once a month or something like that, even less than that. So, and if you prepare, like the meeting should take less than an hour if you prepare beforehand. So.
Thank you. So is there anyone who'd like to nominate? Yes, Jeremiah?
Me, I would like to nominate Hirsch.
Is there anyone else who'd like to nominate themselves? If not, we can move to a direct motion to appoint.
I motion to appoint.
Okay. Do you have a second? Jared, in the spirit of allowing people to motivate for themselves, Peter, why would you like to sit on student life?
Yeah, it's just that I think that I have done student life before, and as a former counselor who has been on student life before, I wanted to give my time. And also, it's my last semester before I graduate, so I really wanted to give my time again to student life and help them with the project and stuff.
All right, thank you. Okay, so there's a motion to appoint Peter on the floor currently. All those in favor of appointing Peter to student life, please raise your placards. I'm 15. All those opposed?
You can abstain.
Zero and opposition?
Yeah.
Two? Is that two?
Yes,
okay.
I'm in opposition as well.
Okay, so two opposed and any extensions? One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so that carries. Congratulations, Peter. You're on the Student Life Committee. And with that, we can go forward to the External Committee. And Isaiah, you're here to motivate for your committee.
Hi. Hey, guys. The External Committee have some awesome counselors who review projects and go over the different possible events that could happen in the year. So I look to collaborate with certain events like Hannah with the poetry night we do. And then also just looking over grant applications for different different students that have projects that fit the positions book. Availability is literally when everyone's able to meet. And yeah.
All right. Is there anyone who would like to nominate themselves or someone else to external committee? If there's nothing, it'll just come back. Yes, Hannah?
I'd like to nominate
Elizabeth
for consent.
Okay.
No.
That's fine. Okay, we have a second for Peter. Howard? Lauren?
Commitment for it?
Time commitment?
Yes.
Whenever you move, like, I don't meet all the time, but whenever we get an application, so it's rolling.
Okay.
Approximation.
Yeah, do we have a second? Okay, we have a second.
I'll nominate for myself as well.
Oh, okay, I would just need a second for Lauren. Salman? Okay, so Lauren and Jeremiah, do we have a second for Jeremiah? Howard? Is there anyone else? Okay, so if not, we can move to motivations. Lauren, why would you like to sit on external?
It sounds like fun, and I've really enjoyed my time on the Student Life Committee, and I would love to work with Isaiah, and I just want to get more involved with the CSU.
All right, thank you. And Jeremiah?
When I originally I wasn't going to apply to any other committees because I figured with the Student Council, Student Life Committee, and you know, my job in school, I have a lot of time on my plate. I mean, I have a lot of stuff on my plate. But when Isaiah just mentioned, like, whenever we get a new application, whatever, I realized I might have the time for this. And I do want to, you know, spread out my resources and put my input on a lot of things. So personally, it's a matter of wanting to gain experience and, you know, giving my point of view on things.
Alright. Is there anyone who'd like to motivate for either candidate or discuss?
So the current candidates are Jeremiah?
Yes.
Like, are we allowed, like, to motivate against or ask questions?
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, okay, so
Lauren and Jeremiah. And Lauren, give the floor.
I'm just wondering for you, Jeremiah, like, you said...
Okay, folks, please be quiet. Lauren has the floor.
Like, how do you have time for this? Because for the Student Life Committee, you only, like, said that you could meet for the Student Life Committee for, like, 1 hour of the entire week. So how, and if you're saying you have a lot on your plate and you didn't even have time for Student Life Committee, how are you going to have time for this?
I'm going to respond that with two responses. First is that my Monday schedule just cleared up. And second is that from what I heard, maybe I misheard, and if I did mishear, then I will retract my nomination. But what I heard from Isaiah is that we don't meet, let's say, once every week. We meet whenever the new application comes in.
Okay, that's the same for the Student Life Committee as well.
Sometimes it's like Ed doesn't meet every, well, at the time it wasn't every Friday, but I send out a when to meet based off everybody's availabilities. So if you're only available Monday or Friday, chances are you might not be, like, historically I've most met on Wednesdays, for example. So I'm like, based off everyone's availabilities, we, with whoever the new player is in the game, whether it's yourself or Lauren, we'll, like, see whose schedule works better, but, I mean, not works better, but, like, fits in. So whoever's joining it, you can't, like, I need you to be available, because if it's a Monday, a Tuesday, a Wednesday, a Thursday, a Friday, maybe even a Saturday or Sunday, depending on how people are feeling, but, like, we do have applications, and I'm trying to get a meeting ASAP.
Right,
you know
what?
So I'll retract
my nomination.
Okay, so in that case, we just need a
motion to appoint Lauren. I would like a motion to appoint Lauren. Okay, seconded by Aman. Okay, folks, is there any opposition to appointing Lauren to the student external committee? All right, so that carries. Congratulations, Lauren. You are on the external committee. So if there's nothing further in appointments, we just have a couple of points of returning business to continue with, beginning with academic caucus minutes, and this one was pulled in November.
Do I not have appointments?
November.
Sorry, do you not have what?
They were done.
They were done. Nobody nominated themselves. Cool. Sorry. Okay, so at this point we are on 7A, which is academic caucus minutes, and Naomi, this one's yours.
Okay. I pulled out the academic caucus minutes because I noticed that the name of Bakri was on it, and that never went through a point. I'm not sure if I should be doing this in closed session.
Okay.
So.
I motion to go into closed session.
Okay. I'll second it. Victoria, is there any opposition to going into closed session?
Well, wait. Quick question. Just do it at the end then, so we could kick out.
Well, no, because the next two go into closed. And the next one are closed.
Okay, so it kind of makes
sense.
Yeah, it does.
Okay. So is there any opposition to closed session? Okay, so in that case, I just ask everyone that's not council executive to, there's two more, but it goes close, open. So these shouldn't take long though.
Okay.
Like setting the election dates is super quick,
yeah.
And mandate report too, I presume. Okay, so at this point we're in closed session. Sorry, I have to ask you to leave, and then we'll invite everyone back at, when we're in open.
325, and polling period would be March 17, 18, and 19. Be it resolved that the budgetary impact of this motion is nil.
Okay, thank you. Do we have a second?
I'll second it.
Victoria, your motivation?
So the motivation is there are no set election dates for the CSU, so every year it's basically in the hands of the CEO to call the election dates, and it ends up being different, and some people prefer to put it one place, some people prefer to put it another. And also, candidates don't get advance notice on when their election dates are, so it makes it hard to plan for the semester, it makes it hard to know when you want to have your team together, it makes it hard to think about running. So this just makes things a lot more organized, and also, I really want to book the Metro Tunnel. There's a big advertising spot, and in order to do that, I would have to have set election dates. So those are the reasons.
All right, thank you. Hannah?
I have 2 points. One, would this be fixed forever or just for this election?
This is only for this election.
Okay.
I am currently working on elections policies with Patrick and the committee. At policy committee with the committee, and they will feature fixed election dates for the future.
Right, thank you.
I have a second point.
Yep.
Because in the last years, it's always been more towards the elections have always been more towards the end of March or beginning of April last year. And this would give, especially with the poll only being announced on February 17th, this would give people who do not have an insight on the CSU and know about this less time to prepare and less notice, unless this is already, like, this is going to be publicized before February 17th. That's the point.
Actually, so first of all, the announcement of the poll is just a formality. So the announcement of a poll is a mechanism in the standing regulations. And in the current system, the announcement of the poll is supposed to be even earlier. So this is actually pushing it off. The only thing that's going, nomination period is way longer now. And the campaigning period is set to 6 days. In the past, it has been made 14 days, which could be pretty intense on teams. I've heard that criticism from Speak Up in the past. They said it's way too long, never do that again. That's why last year it was only six university days. The only thing that's been moved back is the polling period, but nomination period's been moved back so much that, like, there's way more time to prepare in this system. And if you want to look at the current standing regulations, it's buying everybody a lot more time than you usually would have.
Okay.
That was the spirit.
Thank you, James.
Yeah, no, I think it's a great idea. I call the question.
I second it.
Spoken enough for it. There's a bit of a speakers list. Give it like 4 more people.
Hirsch?
I already said
yeah.
It. You
Arad?
How many people left after me?
There's Arad, Isaiah, and Victoria.
I still call the question. Victoria's going to call
there's only been there's only been 3 speakers yet.
Irisin.
No, I think it's a great idea. You see, I think it's a great idea.
Kind of like from being an outsider of the CSU before, typically, hopefully, knock on, well, I don't see any wood nearby, but like the whole team doesn't get disqualified. But if it does, this kind of gives JB that time to kind of get it done before transition, because the later you go to March and April, you have finals, and then also like turnovers in May. So if you get to a point where JB doesn't make a decision by May, then we're in the same boat that last year ended up.
Can I count? We're not at seven people yet, or eight.
Oh,
right?
We're in your last
one. Oh, yeah, I'm the last one. Perfect. So I'd like to call the question.
Okay. It doesn't necessarily need to be called because there's no one else on the list.
Cool.
But,
I second to myself.
No, I second to her.
Sorry?
But by calling it,
yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Like, we're basically
so we
saying no one else throw yourself on that list.
We're all in favor of voting. All right, so all those in favor of the setting the election dates motion as read by Chris, please raise your placards. All those opposed, zero, and any abstentions? One, two, three. All right. Okay. So that carries, and if there's nothing further on the election dates, we can move on to the mid-mandate report, and Hirsch, you pulled this one.
Okay. So the mid-mandate report, the first, let me just find it, sorry. All right, so the first line of it is something along the lines of the CSU represents 35,000 students, undergraduate students. Now, in the past election, we've had 31,000 possible electors, of which only 5,200 voted. So, I mean, the number is definitely wrong. So I would like to motion to have the general coordinator correct the number to reflect the number of students that have voted, because ultimately we can only represent that many. We just don't have any data on the rest.
I'd
like to speak against that.
Do we have actually, you kind of prefaced it before doing the motion.
I'm sorry, what's the motion?
Sorry, yeah, I didn't quite understand.
Okay,
yeah.
Right, so the motion on the table is to not ratify the mid-mandate report, and to have the general coordinator change the line of it, which states that we represent 35,000 undergraduate students, to change it to reflect the number of students that actually voted.
Okay, do we have a second?
No.
Mitchell, do you want to motivate?
Go
ahead, and then I'll...
No, so there's a few points. One is the fact that we don't actually have 35,000 undergraduate students. That's the more of a technical... do you have a question?
Yeah, just finish and I'll take this question.
So we don't actually have 35,000 undergraduate students, so it's kind of awkward that we're claiming to represent people that don't actually exist. There's also the fact that we are claiming to represent all of the students that, in addition to the ones that we're claiming that don't exist, we're also claiming to represent all the students that do exist, of which we've never actually, of the current students, we've never explicitly asked them for their permission and their consent to represent them. And in the past years, there have been students that have expressed the idea that they do not wish to be considered to be represented by the CSU. So especially considering that when I was going around collecting signatures, I've found that most of the students I spoke to did not know what the CSU was. So we can honestly, the only students that we can honestly claim to represent are the ones that voted.
Right, thank you. Isaiah?
All right. My point of information is when you say, am I in the speaker's list? Point of information. When you say students voted, you mean the actual total counter? Or do you mean like the 31,000? So you mean like, are you saying that we represent
the 5,200 that voted?
So then a few points to that. One, the CSU is legally obligated to represent, like it's legally obligated to represent all students, whether they like it or not.
Sorry.
Two, everybody pays into the union. So based off the fee, whether people know what it is or not, or want it to represent, they are still represented. Like we represent, every decision we make speaks for the Concordia population, whether it votes or it doesn't vote, because they pay in their fee. The moment that you pay the CSU fee levy, then CSU is representing all of you. So saying that we have 5,000 voting students, maybe that speaks into our participation rate, but in terms of our representation rate, it's much, like when we go to speak with the admin and go in the meetings and go for all these different committees, we're not just representing the 5,000 people that vote, we're representing every single student at Concordia, no matter what faculty or if they're independent student. Like, so that wouldn't even make sense to me. And then the The third thing, 5,000 to 2,000, is I believe that the system, like the one that we had, like the Excel sheet we have, is not most most accurate. The admin don't share their explicit list sometimes. So it's like we just match their number. They say we represent around 35,000. So we take the admin at their words because they're the ones that actually collect the fees, have the student IDs. So for us to be like 31,000 and then Concordia's like 35,000, it's like, it looks like somebody's incompetent.
Okay, thank you. Mary?
In addition to that, more than 5,000 students are registered under the insurance, which we negotiated for them. There's the Accreditation Act of Quebec, where we're an accredited association, so we're now recognized as the only organization representing you guys, the students, and that's all the students. We have students who use HOJO who haven't voted, who use advocacy who haven't voted. We have I know a lot of the clubs that I represent or I work for don't vote because they don't believe in it.
Thank you. Lauren?
So one point, like Chris, like when I was talking to Chris during my meeting, it actually increased the number of students that voted from the previous year, so it is going up, and having the election day and like being able to market that better, I think if you want more people to vote, you should just make more marketing, and I'd like to finish that by calling the question for this.
I'd like to call the question, please.
Okay, do we have a second for calling the question?
No.
Okay, Arad,
those are cute.
Is there any opposition to calling the question? Okay, so we'll move to a vote. So all those in favor of calling the question, please raise your placards.
Passion.
18, all those opposed. 1, 2, 3, and any extensions?
Sorry, guys, but we're
going to
move on.
No, this. Okay, so the call to question carries. So we'll vote on Hirsch's motion, which was to not approve the report and have it resubmitted with the numbers changed. So all those in favor of that motion, please raise your placards. 1, 2, all those, sorry, was that a 3, Sean?
Yeah.
Okay, 3, all those opposed. 1, 2, 15, and any abstentions? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so in that case, the motion fails. And Patrick?
I move to approve the mandate report.
Okay, do we have a second? Lauren, do you want to motivate?
Folks,
Patrick has the floor.
I just want to say that this was a huge team effort. We worked extremely hard. I was with Isaiah in the office until 1 a.m., and he like we put this together. This was something that like was a huge team effort. I'm really proud of it. But yeah. Anyways, that's. I hope you approve our mid-mandate report. That's all I have to say.
Thank you. Yes, Hirsch.
Just a general comment. This wasn't meant as a criticism of anyone. It just had to do with what I think it's just sort of dishonest when we considering the fact that when we go to the administration to claim. The students have told us to do something. It's the students that voted that told us to do something. 80% or 90, well, 80% in this case did not, which is actually a credit to you guys that it's so, that the number of students that didn't vote is in the 80s instead of 90s.
You're not allowed to talk about a topic we already moved on from.
Oh,
yeah.
My bad.
No, well, we just did a motion. Like the agenda point still exists.
Yeah, it's the same
yeah.
point with a different
sorry,
it was just, yeah.
It does the 80% have a right to not vote on?
Anyway,
okay,
so
yeah, Hirsch,
I just wanted to clarify, it wasn't a personal thing.
Okay.
It's not that I disapprove of the...
No, because there's these things that we have
to do. Sorry. Yeah, I think that at the end of the day, the burden always falls on the voter. So in the sense that it's people's responsibility to go out and vote, regardless of, you know, what happens, how many people vote. Two people could vote out of all 31,000, 35,000, it doesn't really matter. If you're a student, you know your responsibilities, and if you don't know your responsibilities, you need to go out and learn your responsibilities. So if 30,000 people decided not to vote, that's on them.
Just a reminder, the motion on the floor right now is to approve the report or not. Victoria?
I would like to call the question on whether or not we were approving or disapproving the report.
On
approving.
Is everyone okay with voting?
Yeah.
Thank
perfect.
You.
So all those in favor of approving the report, please raise your placards.
Yeah.
21, all those opposed. 0 and any extensions? 1. Okay, so that carries. The report is approved. And with that, there's nothing further on the mid-mandate report. Also, by the way, congratulations, folks. That was a really impressive document. It's always really long and exhausting to write those giant reports. So with that, there is no new business informational. And we're at question period and business arising. So if you recall, it has to do with things that may have come up during the meeting. If you have any questions or any business arising. Peter and then Desiree.
You can go first.
Okay. Wait. I reset actually, I just forgot.
Okay. Peter? Tired.
Yeah, okay. So I just want to say a few things with counselors. These years old.
I'm not sure if it's personal privilege, but I think if we're going to talk maybe about this, we might want
to
go to closed session.
Okay, please stop interrupting. Sorry.
I think we should move
it. It's up to the counselor if they want to.
I need to talk about, because this counselors right now has been doing something that is not acceptable, because they are basically can...
Okay, Peter, take it down a tone,
like,
please.
Why, like... I wanted to ask everyone, like, would you guys be acceptable if someone sending you a message at 1 a.m., though?
I'm sorry.
Okay, please stop interrupting, folks.
Like, this happened on Sunday, I understand that, and then it keeps going, and then last night, someone would send me a message telling me that I'm doing everything wrong at one a.m. like this. Yes, I'm not asleep. Yes, I've been looking at messages, but like you just can't be doing this as a customer. We just can't be doing this all the time and going back and forth all the time like this.
Okay. Yes.
This is not an appropriate topic to be brought up in council as a board of directors for council.
Especially
and so if it's going to be brought up, it A, needs to be in a closed session firsthand. And then B,
and
like,
second of all,
I don't even think it should be brought up.
We have to decide what's enclosed and what's not enclosed. That being said, I really want to stress the fact that interpersonal conflicts should really be discussed outside of council and fixed there. This isn't really the place to talk about it. Your complaint is noted, but beyond that, I would really like to move on from this discussion and not have it become a back and forth.
But that's,
so,
can I just say something?
There was nothing directed at you.
Point of
okay.
Personal.
Chris?
I'm not saying who I agree with in this room, but when people are talking, please just let them finish their turn and then speak, because it invalidates whatever you're about to say. It invalidates it.
Okay, thank you. Peter, your complaint is noted. There was no direct personal attacks on anyone. It was made as a generalization. And with that, I am saying we should move on from this topic. Jared?
Oh, yeah, I agree this shouldn't happen in council. This is not a count. This might involve counselors. This is a personal conflict. So I don't think we have any other announcements or question, business arising, anything like that. I move to adjourn.
Actually, that's not...
Is that not true?
There might be announcements still coming.
Are there announcements?
Yeah, usually people have a couple.
There are any announcements that I move for sure.
Can I just say something?
Patrick, you have the floor?
I pulled the orders of the day.
Okay,
it's just a general statement that I'd like to make.
I promise it's general.
Okay.
I promise it's not, like, attacking anybody. It's just a general statement for everyone in this room. Like, I just want everyone to remember that we are a team. Like, as much as it sucks and as much as everybody, like, maybe doesn't interpret what everybody says, like, the way they mean it, we are a team. We should not be speaking ill of each other. We should not be doing anything to destroy each other, because we are one, and we are one on an image together. Sorry, I'm stuttering. I'm literally shooketh. I've had the worst week of my life, and honestly, after this whole thing, it's whatever. But just remember that we are a team. If one person on this team screws up, that means we all screwed up. So just keep that in mind. I just wanted to put that out there. Thank you.
Here.
Hirsch?
I just want to clarify the incident that occurred at the last meeting.
There was an assertion made that a particular committee was not a particularly significant, there was nothing sneaky going on in it, and that it would not be, it's not such a big deal if those who want or don't want to be on it. And a certain candidate nominated himself for it, and two other counselors jumped on him, and, like, it was incredible how, like, well, they... brought forward a motion to nominate, they tried nominating someone who had not given his consent and then demanded that the room wait on the nomination before, until that person came back.
Yeah, in business arising, it should have been discussed last meeting if there was an issue. This is business arising from this meeting.
You can bring it up if you want, but this is not the topic here.
I really want to stress that we need to solve our interpersonal conflicts outside of the meeting.
That being said,
okay, Peter, please stop. Okay, that being said, as we are still on announcements, I was going to say it occurred to me that there's a lot of new counselors, and the former, or not former counselors, but the veteran counselors, I guess, had received a lot of training at the beginning of the year. So I was going to ask if anyone was interested in having the Roberts Rules training redone. If any new counselors would be down for that.
Caitlin, I think we should just offer it.
Yeah, that's what I was going
to. We're going to offer it.
Okay.
About that.
Okay. Awesome. We'll figure out dates and times. Okay, so moving on in announcements and such, Hannah?
I think Marin's working on that, but that the consent training is also being scheduled, right, for the new councillors, because that is mandatory before February 1st.
So consent, Robert's rules,
and 3 weeks notice before
the sexual assault policy
the consent training, according to the policy.
Yeah, let's do it one time.
Okay, thank you.
I just missed, the last 30 seconds of, whatever was discussed. I just heard things, there's dates, and I just want clarification.
Could you just repeat?
Okay, so in the, I believe it's the sexual violence and safer spaces policy, it says that any councillors elected during by-elections have to have consent training by February 1st, and they need to be given two dates of possibilities when to take that training, and it's encouraged to be done on a Wednesday night when councillors have already that the time reserved for council, and they have to be given 3 weeks notice. So the deadlines might not be.
But I'm sure if it was brought up.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to start to schedule a date. And then I'll try to do a when to meet for the new counselors so that I don't have to schedule it before the meeting, as long as everyone's available. Okay, thank you. Amanda?
And this is in addition to the consent and forms that we filled out as a school body?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's identical.
Sorry? It's identical?
It's identical, but it's in addition.
Okay.
Thank you. Howard?
Point of information, is this consent training in person or online?
It has to be in person.
In person, okay.
It's going
to
be 3 hours.
Okay.
So if there's no more questions, business rising, announcements first. If anyone has any announcements, execs, counselors, Elizabeth?
Okay, so BIPOC is collaborating with SEED and ASAC and Acción, and so we have an event on February 1st. It's Women in the Workforce, Diversity and Leadership. So it's a conference and networking event. It's going to be at Grey Nuns. So if you guys are interested in coming to that February 1st, Saturday night, it's going to be great. It's going to be food. So, yeah, that's it.
Jared?
I motion to adjourn.
Second. Sorry, go ahead.
Thursday, and it's gonna be there's gonna be one lecture in CJ, but there's another one in Oscar Peterson. If you're a comm student, you get free food. If you're not, sucks to be you, but you still get free lecture. So,
all right, thank you. Okay, Jared, go ahead.
I motion to adjourn.
Second. All right, folks, meeting adjourned.
Yes.
Not so good.